Welcome to this short video on getting started with EndNote 20. In this video, I will be explaining what is EndNote, how to create an EndNote library, and what EndNote support is available at Murdoch Library. What is EndNote? EndNote is a referencing management software that helps you to manage your references, add citations in Word documents, add bibliographies in Word documents, and format them in the appropriate style. EndNote will not teach you how to reference correctly. You need to know how to do that before using any referencing management software. Murdoch University has a license for EndNote, which allows you to download a copy to your own device for your research and study. You can download EndNote on the Murdoch Library EndNote Guide. The first time you use EndNote, you'll need to create a library to store your data. To create an EndNote library, select File, New, and select a location to save it in. When selecting a location, do not save it on the USB drive or cloud drive such as Dropbox, iCloud. These are fine to store backups but not working libraries. Give your library a unique name and click Save. This will create two files with the same name, a library file and a folder of data files. Both files need to be in the same location in order for EndNote to work correctly. A handy tip is to keep all your references together in one EndNote library rather than creating multiple libraries. This will avoid problems when writing papers or moving files between computers. Now that you've set up your library, you are ready to start adding references into your library. There are many ways to add references to EndNote. In this video, we will look at how to manually add a reference, how to preview and select your referencing style, as well as how to export a reference from a library search and a database. We will start with manual entry so that you become familiar with the database fields and know how to edit records if needed. It is also useful in situations when automated data import is not possible. For example, when adding a website or grey literature. To get started with adding a manual reference, click the icon. A new reference window will open. Select the relevant reference type and enter in any reference data that you have. Save the reference by clicking Save and then close the pop-up window when you have finished. A handy tip, when entering a corporate author, an organization and not a person, put a comma after the full name so that it will appear correctly. Otherwise, EndNote will assume that the last word is a family name and may invert the order according to your style. Now let's preview your reference. In the preview section of the Summary tab on the reference panel, you'll be able to see how a reference would look in a document, using the referencing style of your choice. To select your required referencing style, select the appropriate style in the toolbar under Tools and Output Styles. To see a preview of the reference in that style, click on the reference you want to view. On the right panel, select Summary at the top. If the citation is not showing on the bottom right, click the arrow next to Copy Citation to open the preview panel. Now we're going to take a look at how we export references from our library search. On the library search results page, you can either add individual references or you can add a group. To add a single reference, click on the three-dot icon and select EndNote. To add a group of references, click on the folder icon and save a reference to the saved items folder on the top right. Open the saved items folder and select EndNote from the export to drop-down menu. In either case, a RIS file will be downloaded. This will be either in your downloads folder, but depending on your computer settings, this could either be on the desktop, documents, or another folder. Depending on your browser, you can also access the RIS file in various places, such as the bottom bar or the download icon. To complete the import, open the RIS file, and this will automatically import the reference into EndNote. Your references will appear in the imported references group. The number in brackets is the number of records in that group. This is only a temporary holding place, and as soon as you import more references or close the EndNote program, the references will disappear. Imported references will always be available under all references. A handy tip, this is the best time to check your references for errors, as it's easier than searching for it later. Check all the data in each reference is correct, and remember to save your changes. Once you've added the references to EndNote, you'll no longer need the RIS file, and you can delete this if you wish. Now we're going to take a look at how to export a reference from a database. Most databases can export directly to EndNote, and this will be the easiest and best way to do so in terms of metadata quality. Look out for words like export, cite, save, RIS format to identify this functionality. For this example, we will be using the Scopus database. To export citations from Scopus into your EndNote library, mark the results that you like and click Export just above the results list. This will open Export Document Settings window. Select RIS Format, then click Export. The references will appear in the Imported References group. Now that you have your references sitting within your library, you are ready to start adding references into your Word document. In this video, I will be explaining how to create InText citations, how to edit your InText citations, deleting the citations, and how to back up your EndNote library. When you install EndNote on your computer, it also installs a plugin for Word called Cite While You Write. This automatically allows you to add citations and create bibliographies or reference lists automatically. Before you add a reference in Word, you will first need to ensure that your referencing style that you use matches the one in EndNote. To do this, in Word, click on the EndNote 20 tab in the ribbon. In the Style drop-down menu, choose the referencing style that matches the style you have selected in EndNote. If the style you need is not available from the drop-down menu, click Select Another Style. Select the style you want to add and click OK. To insert an author date citation, in EndNote, find the reference you want to use and select by clicking on it. Return to Word and click on the arrow next to Insert Citation. Select Insert Selected Citation. Once a citation has been added, a full reference will also be added to the bibliography or reference list at the end of your document. A handy tip is that you can also use the Insert Citation option to search for another reference. So now we're going to take a look at how we edit an InText citation. It's very important to note that once you have inserted a citation, you should not edit it directly. If you make any changes within the brackets of a citation, it will disappear when the bibliography reformats. Instead, you must use Edit and Manage Citations. To edit a citation, select or highlight the reference. Click Edit and Manage Citations. The Edit and Manage Citations dialog box will open. On the Edit Citations tab, select the drop-down menu beside Formatting. Choose the formatting that you want. For example, exclude author. Add prefixes, suffixes, or page numbers as required and click OK. Now let's look at how we delete a citation. To delete a citation, select and highlight the reference. Click Edit and Manage Citations. Click the down arrow next to Edit Reference and select Remove Citation. If you do not cite the reference anywhere else on your paper, the entry will also be removed from your bibliography or reference list. If you delete or edit your citation directly, there is a risk that you may corrupt your work, which is something you do not want to do. To avoid this in future, use the Edit and Manage Citation button and develop good habits when using EndNote. One of these good habits includes backing up your EndNote library. We always recommend making regular backups of your EndNote library in case something goes wrong further down the track. To save a copy of your library at a specific point in time as a backup, go to File and Save a Copy. Name the backup copy. A handy tip is to include the date in the file name. Save the backup ENL and data files on different drive or a USB. Please note, save a copy will not overwrite the existing file. Now that you know about using EndNote and Word, you are ready to start adding references into your Word document. Check out our other short videos or comprehensive guide to learn more. You can also reach out to our librarians who can help you with any specific EndNote queries.